content. Come on, stay alive. Stay alive, stay alive, stay alive, stay alive. Come on. Where is it? Where's I am live. Fantastic. Right. So I can get rid of that. Okay. Right. Hello guys, my name is Ben. So welcome to the live stream. Today is gonna be, well, I said today. Later today is gonna be a bit more of Euro Truck Simulator 2. More specifically, it is going to be the Advanced Coupling upgrade. The 1.24 update to ETS2, and we're gonna have a quick look at that, and then we're gonna go on to do some multiplayer. And we're gonna have a look at the car on there as well. So at the moment, I'm driving this Volvo, and we're going to drive a trailer at Grimsby, I believe. Grimsby? Oh, didn't want to do that. Go away. Yeah, Grimsby. So we're heading to Grimsby. I'll drop the trailer, and we'll have a look at the hitching up. We'll also get to see what when it drops off as well. Obviously, this is a beta, open beta. So some of the mods aren't working. So I've still got the. Did you let me go? Or what? Cool. I've still got stuff like the Scania T series that still all works because that's Steam Workshop and that. But the Advanced Coupling doesn't work with that mod. Doesn't work with the Scania T series. I have tested that. Squirrel did also do a test video as well of his own where he tested modded trucks and modded trailers and neither worked. Oh, sorry, the modded trailer did, but it was a bit finicky. So, I tested the T-Series, and that didn't work, so I can't use that. That's why I'm using the old trusty Thor. I have tested it, it definitely does work. And personally, I don't mean to sound big-headed, but I like to line up my truck bang on with a trailer anyway, unless I'm in a real rush. So I don't know if this is going to be any different for me personally. I feel like a bit dickhead saying this. I'll just be going 50. 50? It's 50. And, oh, the car's underneath one of that noise was. The only difference is when you do back up to it and you lock in, then you then can't move. You then have to press T to then wind up the legs and actually release yourself to be able to go. So technically, hitch up the lines. So once you hitch up the lines, you then release the power brake on the trailer. So it allows all that. Also, you see the animation for winding up the trailer legs. You get all that certain stuff. Gives a nice sense of realism to it. The actual animation for winding up the legs, that's in the game, that's fixed into the game, that doesn't change. That is it. You can't turn that one off, that's new, that ain't going anywhere. The advanced trailer connection is literally just the where you back on and connect up to the kingpin on the trailer, which will pin. You have to line up the truck with the trailer. Well, not sorry. Yeah, you have to line up the truck. That's the easiest way of doing it. That's the only way you're going to see to actually line up the actual two bits. But the actual lining up, you have to line up the actual fifth wheel, the trailer connection on the truck, with the kingpin, or the actual pin on the trailer. Those are the bits you've got to line up properly. As long as you've got those two lined up properly, you can then do any way you want. You can connect it up any way you want to. And we will test that. That's one thing Squirrel didn't test, and that's not something I'm going to test, is can you, as long as you've got the fifth wheel pin lined up, then will it still work? Because that is something you can do in real life. Sometimes you need to pull a trailer out of a sticky situation, and sometimes you can't put the trailer on actual in line with, you can't actually put the truck in line with the trailer, sometimes you have to. Sometimes you have to collect up at a funny angle to get the trailer out. So that is something we should test. It's been a while since I've driven on 4. I do miss the old girl. The old headlights on, a bit dark. Yes, once you've had a good look at, once you've had a good look at this advanced cover, we'll see it happen a few times, see the old drop offs, then I'll move it over. I'll have to downgrade the game, but I'll keep talking in the meantime. I'll have to downgrade the game back to 1.23 and then we'll go on to multiplayer. Oh, we'll go on to EU2 server, where we will have a fiddle with the new car they've introduced, the scout car as they call it. Basically a Skoda Superb, basically. They have different liveries with it. It does cost money. It's not something you just get given. Obviously you have to have the latest version of that's your multiplayer application, or the multiplayer mod, I should say. In this lane. And stop. Sorry about the TV, I keep watching the TV, yes, I better turn that off really. Oh fuck, the TV's gone into it for spares. Hold on, let me just sort this out, but I'm gonna sort the TV before it crashes out. Hold on a second. That's carry on. Ah, apologies about that. Had a bit of a clash of the old TV recordings going on there. Right. Da 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 da. That's a Diddy trailer, isn't it? That's why. Right, so we get this back into the hole. Take it out reverse. Put the handbrake on. Let's take a look at outside. Is there a free cab button? What was the free cab button? Let me have a look. Let me have a look properly. So, let's have a look. ETS 2 free free camera. I'm sure there's a button for it. Not that. It's had on them console control. Okay, don't worry about that. We'll try and do it with the number two in the camera. Right, let's have a look outside. So we can see, just about see the landing legs there and the handle on this side as well. I've noticed the handles are on different sides. So normally, I found trailers normally have them on this truck, the driver's side. So if we press T. I forgot it does that. Alright, go to the truck. Go to the truck. So yeah, the legs do go down now. You got the old, you can hear the gears of the landing legs going down to actually wind down and hit the ground. Now, does the trailer actually hit the ground? Yeah. The trailer legs are on the ground. We've had, some people have put videos up where the legs don't actually hit the ground and yada yada. That's not such an issue. Yeah, there we go. So, the reversing up and dropping off a trailer is of no difference whatsoever. Let's just literally drive through this one and pick up whatever trailer it is. Oh, gone too far. Enter. So, frame marker. Grimsby. Let's pick up this normal curtain side trailer. Let's back up behind that. Do it slowly. Oh, it's right there. So, if I line this up about here, and then let's press 2. Back, and see if it moves, because I've seen some of them when they let you, the trailer actually lifts up. This one doesn't. But there. Banging, it locks in. So the trailer is now connected to the truck, so locked in, but not properly connected. It's literally just the fifth wheel connection locked in. So in reality, you haven't got your airlines connected up or your electricity connections for your lights and that. It's literally just banged in. To actually properly finish off the connection, so connect your airlines and lift up the legs, you press T. And then that completes it. So there you go. You wind up your legs, your lights come on, that's the job complete. And we can now drive off with it. And the same, if we press T, it disconnects. And the difference is obviously in that disconnection procedure, the guy, whoever it is, pulls out the handle, which operates the mechanism to release the actual pin, and all you do is you just drive out. So what we want to test is, so we want to add two squirrels testing, is actually seeing if we can connect this up at different angles. So let's just back up, let's go this way. Sorry. So we roll back here now. I'm hoping, as long as the fifth wheel is in line, it should still connect. Could be interesting. I'm trying to guess where they're fucking. It's not easy without a free cam. It's about there. It does. There you go. Absolutely fantastic. Also, something you might have noticed was, let's connect that up. And release it. So you might have just noticed is, so this, I can't really point, can I? Can I do this? There you go. So this here is obviously the fifth wheel connection. On this fifth wheel, you actually have this V-shaped edge or taper, which actually guides. If you get to a certain point, and as long as you've got the pin within that area, even if it's pins there, it will either move the trailer or move the rear of the truck to line up the pin and guide it into where it should be, which is within there. And that's something they have animated into it. So if you get the pin within that area, it does move over. Let's see if we can do it again, actually. So I just want to go offset a bit. About there. Let's reverse it back. Let's see what we get. Watch the rear of the truck or the trailer. It shouldn't move. Take it nice and slow. No, we've missed it completely actually on this one. Let's head over this way a bit. Let's try again. There. You see, did you just see it? Just as before it connected, it moved the rear of the truck to line up with the pin. Obviously more off you are, well, as long as you're in that area, but a bit more if you're off, then it does move the whole thing over. Actually, show it a bit better by actually doing it properly lined up ish so we end up not lining ourselves up properly. So if I get lined up but then go slightly off, I should drag something. Oh, okay, maybe that was a better connection I thought it was going to be. Oh, there. Let's take a right out. Try that again, down this way. Come on, work me, you bitch. There you go, whole thing moves, lines it all up. So, they've actually done quite a good job of it, actually. I did make a little bit of a complaint about it on YouTube. I did leave a comment on there, just saying, you know, you got the animation for the legs, why have you got the animation for the airline electrical connections? But they have not turned on the lights once you actually connect up. So once you actually press the T, that then completes the operation for a connection, which is nice. That's a good touch. So. I'm quite impressed with that actually. That's not bad, that's quite good. Okay, right, so we're done with that. We don't need to look at that anymore. We are going to go and look at the car. So, give me a second, it's going to be a black screen for a little while, just also sort out my game. Obviously I need to now downgrade again, or return it back to, whatchamacallit, hood and a flap. 1.23. Yep, successfully opted out. Now downloading. Now installing. I don't have a little bit more information about Pokemon Apex. Obviously, I did say I was going to try and work on Twitter. I did say I was going to try and look at the development of the game, see if I can find out what's happening with it. The current situation is there's apparently one guy working on it, and he is currently after. He's working on the coding side of it, the actual proper game side of it, the complicated, probably complicated side of it. He's currently after artists, or pixel artists, I think he said. And he's after basically anybody. He'll consider anybody. He just wants to have a chat with, obviously have a chat with you beforehand, trying to have a look at your portfolio, have a look at your work beforehand. So if that's something you're interested in, get in touch with me. Then I'll give you the link to where he will be, and you can go and have a chat with him. But obviously you don't have to like Pokemon, you don't have to like anything. just if you're looking for artistic work within the computer gaming world, and just I could put you in that direction. And it is an up and coming game. I think that is going to be a very popular game eventually. Once it's a bit more finished, there's a bit more to it, I think that's going to be a very popular game. Because I can certainly will have it. And if he makes it, the guy's name is Iron Vishnu. I think his actual proper name is Nate. If he makes it as free roaming as the old games were. So there was an end game and not an end game, if you know what I mean. If he made it like that, then that will be absolutely fantastic. Especially on a PC. Very good. Right, we are ready to play. So that's updated. So now if I click on that, that should give us a game. Looking good so far. Right, so we need it on EU2. The car only works on EU2. I don't know why that is. There's just a reason for that. I don't know. But you also notice, now that the car has been introduced, it makes it a lot more exciting for people. Thus, the numbers have gone up, which is something we did say about. There was quite a low amount of numbers recently. But the bringing of the car in has spiced it up a bit more. Some more numbers are back. And you can tell us for the car, because everyone's on EU2. Actually, there's quite a few on EU1 at the moment, actually. Surprising. Okay. No, it's gone to EU2, which we know the car works. Unless they've added it for EU1, I never know. You don't have to do anything. Charge to upgrade the game to the latest available version. Oh, okay, yeah, no, that's fine. So, multiplayer, you can already see it in the car already. You don't have to mess around with anything like the mod manager or any game files. The car is implemented using when you install a multiplayer mod that puts the car in already. I'm pretty sure you can buy the car at any garage also. Right, so here's the car. This is the one I've used. It's got a bit of blue on it. It's pretty standard. There's not a lot you can do with it. Oh, this isn't the one I got, actually. I put a pilot skin on it. Oh, I don't know. Right, let's look at the truck there. I'm going to show you. I'm pretty sure you can buy it from any dealer. So, there's DAF, Iveco, Scout Extra D. Nice bit of extra D, enough like a bit of extra D, eh? Yeah, so you can buy from any of them. So let's look at this one. So customized configuration, see what there is. So cab, standard. There's no change on that. Chassis, no change. Got two engine options. Why you go for the 160 horsepower, I don't know. No idea at all. Oh, there's a petrol one. So it's a 1.8 TSI engine. And then you've got a 2-litre TDI. I had this engine in my old Audi. It was a very good engine. Gearbox is a manual 6-speed, but you obviously don't have to use the manual option. I do have a H-shifter connected up. I was using it for it, but it just doesn't feel right, so I don't use it. You've actually got a couple of different interior specs. I say a couple, you might choose four, because it's either left-hand or right-hand drive, so you'll only go left hand or right hand, and then reduces you down to two, so you technically only have a couple. So you've got the standard, basically the black with the black dash and all that. Then you go for the exclusive, a bit of wood trim, a bit of cream colored seats and all that, you know, standard stuff. You get a sat nav. It's just basic. It's just a color change. Outside you get a few different colors, quite strange ones. You can have a custom color. This is where I got my blue from. You can have a pilot skin. I thought I bought this, but maybe I didn't. Maybe I decided against it for some reason. I don't know. You can have a pilot skin. Obviously, you've got it on pilot. With a pilot skin, you can use these cars in your convoys. You can send this car well up ahead to clear the road, or you can have it following behind, maybe like a wide load or however way you want to do it, but you can't do it like that. There is a police skin as well, but the police skin I can't use. You can set your car up as a police car, that'll let you buy and everything, but as soon as you log in with it, that'll just boot you off because you'll just say you've got mods on that you can't use, you're not allowed to, you're not a police. So don't use that unless you're an administrator. Yeah, the police cars are for administrators as well. If you're an admin, you get a police car, so you can chase people, basically, act like the police. You have got some customized options, so you have got like a blue light, that'll get you thrown off. You've got the pilot light, which you can use for the other skin, so if we go to this skin, and put that on, you know, quite a decent looking thingamajig-majig. Stock mirrors, you're going to have a plastic, no fog lights, you're going to have halogen fog lights. You have blue LEDs in there, obviously you can boot off for that. Tyres, they don't change, even though you get different options, they don't change. Same with the wheels and tyres, sorry. There's nothing around the back, just wheels and tyres. And then stock mirrors. So there's not a huge amount of customizable options on it, apart from the bodywork, which I like the pilot skin. I'd use it. I will use it eventually. And interior, you can have the number plates on here. Yeah, mirror. I'm sure that's what I had on my other one. Do you want to cancel? Yes. So let's go to my one. Yeah, I swear I had. Oh, connection established. I swear I had one. Oh, maybe I didn't save it. Maybe. Was it a crash? I can't really remember. Anyway, let's get in. Let's have a look. So this is it. You have got the old handbrake.
Sag mal, du Pole, hast du den Arsch auf oder was? Bist du zu dumm zum Fahren oder was?
Kann er meine Hatz haben?
Ja, ist mir vollkommen egal.
Okay, let's get out of this place first.
Kann er meine Hatz haben?
Come on, guys. Let's
do it together. Guys are all listening to anything, mate. There's some lag as well. Let's try and get the petrol station outside of the city. This way, I think. As if I am where I think I am. I always forget. You gotta be careful of these cars. These fucking cars pop out of nowhere. Lagging balls, man. Come on. Ah, fuck it, I'm going ahead of him. Where's my cruise control? It does use the central dash of a, Scania, but I can work around that.
Why it's fine, don't do piss, Nelke!
Someone ain't very happy. Let's just get away from that town. I'm gonna have a look at the old let's go on this bridge, I'm gonna have a look at the car, shall we? We'll get around that. Right, so you got your handbrake animation, you got your sat nav in the middle, you got the old CB radio on the dash, so that works well obviously for
idiots.
For you know, if you are arranging a convoy, you can contact people over the CB radio. Got lights on the dash, got a very nice looking steering wheel. It's very well good looking mod. Yeah, got back seats. The actual sound of the engine actually sounds like a diesel car. The steering I've noticed is a bit finicky, but get around that, it's not bad at all. That is it's a well made mod, I do like it. Look outside. Lights all work, got DRL lights, almost Zenitar style lights, wipers work, fog lights work, high beams, sorry, do we have front auxiliaries? No, okay, the fog lights don't actually work. Oh, this is it, there you go, look at that. Brake lights all work, indicators do work, and reverse works. And the horn does sound like a car horn. Quite a decent sounding car horn, actually. Alright, so let's do a journey, shall we? Now, what I've been doing is I'm using this car to get to places where I haven't actually discovered yet. And it's actually been quite nice journeys. I do stick the speed limit, I'm a good boy. So I also get to the places where I haven't discovered anything like this here, which is probably a chance of that's a recruitment agency. So let's head down the road and let's go there, shall we? Put it in gear, shall we? Like I said, I do use the cruise control. It is very handy. Being non-automatic, you can just sit back and go. But even in my personal car is an automatic. I love automatics. It's so much nicer. This is actually a six-speed manual, so it does go to sixth gear, but for some reason even in 70, doesn't quite go to the sixth gear, which is why I tried using the old six speed pace shifter, but it just still didn't seem right. Couldn't get used to using it. Put the old DRLs on. It does burn fuel quite well, quite a lot actually. You can see the fuel gauge just on the bottom right there, you've got temperature on the bottom left. Then like I say, the central dash is off a Scania, so it's off a truck that we go through. We can actually see the air pressure for brakes. Now cars don't use air pressure brakes, they use hydraulic brakes, so this is completely irrelevant. But I do have air brake simulation activated, I always have had it. So if you don't service your truck, that is damage, that you do lose air pressure, it's like when you're parked up for a while. And it does happen on this, it does lose the immersion a bit, but that's not too bad, I can go over that. But fuel, like, it does burn quite well.
Just trying to have a peaceful drive, but no, apparently I can't have a peaceful drive. How rude of sirs.
Oh, what is this turd? What does he keep complaining for? Oh, hello. That is the only slight problem with having so many people on. You do get a lot of weirdos. It's the best way to say it. bend, sort of bend. No, no. Yeah, but it's also how to... This, having the car does also prove the actual sit back and relaxedness, I suppose, of ETS. So you don't have to pull a big old trailer, you don't have to have a big old load, a big old vehicle. You just have to sit back and enjoy the actual journey. So it doesn't, well, vehicle really is completely irrelevant, really. Which I may actually put more car mods into my ETS game and have a fiddle with them.
I hope all you guys are listening to truckers.fm tonight. We have an amazing DJ, Louise.
I seriously hope he's gonna fucking disappear soon.
Definitely do listen to her. She's only got around half an hour left, so remember to get your requests in at truckers.fm. Also, remember, truckers.
I hope he's just gone. I hope he's just gone. I didn't mess around with vans, so I'd have a smaller vehicle that I could do 70 with, but and have a trailer as well. But a lot of them didn't work. I'm hoping for a few more of them to pop up on the Steam Workshop, so I know they'd work. Sorry, watching TV at the same time there. It's nice to just sit back and have a drive. Oh, turn off here. I think it would be nice also the... Must we have a game where there is actually just highway cruising or highway, and have the back roads sort of driving. That's actually a decent one. I know there are some out there, but they're not as detailed or as nice to actual control. Like, it'd be nice to have a car like this controls. A little bit finicky here and there, but at the end of the day, it's still a nice vehicle to control. I don't know why. I can get into sixth gear. There we go. If I drop down to 7, I'll stay in 6, I hope. No. Okay, maybe that's a little something I have to have a fiddle with the settings, maybe. I'm running out of fuel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally. Oh, you just fucked up some. Gamer Zan, hello, how are you, fella? What's the missus? Oh, she's in a quiz tonight. Let's pull over. I need only fuel, I'm gonna get out in a second. She's in a quiz, she's asked me a question. What is that logo? Let me see if I can get it. What is that? What is that logo? Oh, I do apologize about this, but I better help her. Okay. I do apologize about this. This isn't the best one, is it? No, okay, I can't, I don't know that one. But I'll just tell her that. Wait. Not sure. Hello, can you add some music? Unfortunately, I could not add some music because I'm not a huge fan of royalty free music, and I'm not going to add in any copyright music because I'm trying to get paid for what I do. Gamers, do you have the Logitech G27 or what? I have the Logitech G29. Oh, I forgot to add that in the title, didn't I? Give me a second. Let me change that. And yes, I did need a refuel, so I pulled over. I'll sort that in a second. With Logitech G29. Fantastic Oracle. All changes have been saved. Lovely, let's go away. Right. Let's go and refuel, shall we? What am I doing? That's it, right. And stop. Now how much does this actually cost? I think it cost about 120 odd quid last time. Maybe not. Jesus Christ, £378. Fuel got expensive. Alright, let's carry on. Man, you fucked up. My sunny day. Dun, dun, dun. What's that say? I'm in Stockholm Ghost. I saw him over there actually. Ghosts are everywhere. Please obey the rules. Hmm. admins are a lot more sneaky nowadays. There's still not going to be a lot of mod anyway. There never will be. There's very rarely come on. Maybe they're going to come on with one that they've got a car. They're going to have a bit more fucking power and being a policeman. Which is annoying. If that is going to be the case. Fuck me. He was fucking giving it some. And he wasn't an admin. Do you have Farmer Simulator 15? I do have Farmer Simulator 15. Yes, I do. Keep meaning to get a good stream of that in. But, always forget. Why, do you have it? He's not a happy bunny? I do like a nice chilled back, relax and drive. So I even have a thing in real life where I always try and drive, even if we're going on a long journey. Later, would you play some FS15? Not tonight, unfortunately, mate. There's not a huge amount of time left for me to stream. Tonight, I'm just chilling out, mate. Going for a nice drive with me Scout Extra D. But, you have mentioned it. There is a... Oh, hello. Bit of frame loss there. I do need to work on my farm. I do have a server, if you're interested. Sorry, it's an RVG service, part of our community. But I do have that to play on. I can go on that tomorrow, if you're going to be around tomorrow. Maybe in the evening. I'm never going to be in the afternoon, maybe in the evening. I think.
Dai, Africa, please shut up. Mamma mia, quanto pare.
Yeah, actually, I don't know if I can stream it tomorrow because I've got I'll take my car in to have it be looked at. Actually, if I don't stream it tomorrow, Zan, right, Rainer, if I don't stream it tomorrow, that'll be Friday. So keep an eye out for it if you want to. Might try and do it tomorrow actually, if I can get the missus to give us a hand. She might come on and do some work for us. I subscribed. Oh, thank you very much, fella. That is very kind, thank you. If you want to set up, so there is a way of setting up, there's like a little bell symbol, I can't remember how you do it. You can set up, so... Oh, hello. Oh, fucking hell. Threaded that like a fucking champ. I might have just lost me left hand side of my car, but I've got around it. Yeah, there is an option, so when I do go live, you will get notified of it. You'll get a little notification either on your phone or... however way you want it to be notified. So when I do stream on Farm Sim, you'll get notified of it, so you won't miss it. That's up to you if you want to do that or not. I do try and stream as many days as I can, so if a notification does get annoying, just switch it off, don't bother me. Phone keeps going again. I should not be driving and reading my phone. Oh, turn right, okay. Oh, speeding. Okay, didn't see that. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Brake, 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 brake. Oh, We are in Metz. Stop. Brakes are a bit rubbish on this. What does that say? She asked me more questions. It was Danone. Ah, it was Danone. Yeah, the logo of Danone, that's what it was. So I was right, it was a recruitment agency. Let's just park up in here for a second so I can message me missus. Oh! So I want to quickly do is I am just gonna crank up the braking intensity. Oh, okay, yeah, let's just crank it up, just a tad for the car. I'll keep that as a reference when I turn that back, so just crank it up just a bit. Because the brakes on the car are rubbish. Where's that parking space? Go in this one. Alright, stop. Can we just send a message and we'll plan our next journey? Oh, I have two emails. I do have two emails. I have one email saying GamerZan has subscribed. Thank you again. You got a big picture of a tractor. You do have a big picture of a tractor. I didn't realize that was a big picture of a tractor. What is that? Big old John Deere? Is it? I think it is a John Deere. It's John Deere colours anyway. We're not hugely knowledgeable on tractors. LOL. Fantastic. Lovely jubbly. Right, so where are we going to go next then? Where should we go next? So we have just been to Metz. So the next closest place is Strasbourg, which I haven't been to, so we might as well go there actually. Let's go to Strasbourg. Fuck it, why not? Let's go. Take the handbrake off. That normally helps. See, I'm coming. Nope. Indicator on, we are turning left down here. That brakes are a little bit better. Fuck. Speed the beds again. My ass. The indicator sounds, well, the indicator sounds, I'm pretty sure I've been in a lot of these cars as taxis. I'm sure that's the noise they normally make. If not, very bloody close to that. Right, turn off to Strasbourg. Oh no, it's a big windy one. Should be alright. Keep it to 70. I think someone did. Yeah, I think I just heard the noise. Good old boys. Or girls, maybe girls. Might be a sex string. Oh, hello. We've got an ETOL? I think we have. Still gonna cost me a ridiculous amount to send a car through. Did it say? Or is it the start of a toll? Might just be a start of a toll. Mannheim. Oh, nice little bridge up here. I think the gearing of this car, it is sort of bothering me that it's not going above fifth gear. I think it is more tuned for going at high speeds for police car, basically. Police carring, being a police car. That was the design of it, I think. They can have all the cars I could have picked. I don't know why I picked a Skoda. I don't know why I could just put in like a BMW or something. BMW 5 Series maybe. That's a more, far more commonly used police car. Clayton Santos Salve? Salve? Salva? What does that say? I don't know what that means. What's that? Is that another language? You have to help me out there, boyo. Oh, that's a toll. This is obviously the end of the toll. Some acceleration test after this toll. See how fast this thing can go. Fuck it. Stop. Brakes didn't work. 10%! Fucking hell. £24, that's not so bad. Right, let's go. Floor up. Como Bexia Euro Truck? I don't know what that says, mate. I don't know what that says. Put it in the Google Translate for me, mate. I don't know what that says. Let's see how fast we can get this thing going. Whoa. Back end a bit loose. Hello. Here we go. Don't like bends. Oops. Alright, okay. Well, we're gonna get ourselves to Strasbourg very quickly. Even faster than whatever speed we were just going at. I have discovered Strasbourg by going in on the back of a forklift truck. Worst opera I've ever heard. Only repaired, don't I? Services, what damage do I do? 6 grand, that's not bad at all. Just got a good price considering I just flipped the fucking thing. Right. I haven't actually gone into Strasbourg, so we can still go to that thingamajigamabob. The other thing that does also sort of bomb is in real transmission mode, which I always use, or adaptive transmission, I should say. This car always pulls away in second, which is a little bit annoying. Wait for a green light. Wait and see. Wait to see. Bloody knackered I am. Wait, he's ready for my bait. Let's go. What's this on the right here? Is that another recruitment? That's a Scania dealer, by the looks of it. That was a red light. Okay, I must have changed as I went through it then. It's a little Scania dealer. Alright, let's back this bad boy up. Da 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 dun. Stop. Calibrate then listen. Right, let's go for another journey, shall we? Oh, there's a cold wind now coming in. What we got? Anyone else near us? Got Bern, Geneve, Torino. Or do we go and play some pro mods? Let's go and play some pro mods, I think. Let's come out of this. We're done with the car. Oh, go away. Right. So, let's clear out this. We need to come right out of multiplayer, so get rid of that. Let's fire up. Oh, so please check something quickly. Give me a second. Oh, okay, so I've got streamer mode, okay. Okay. Sorry, I was having a quick look at the chat. I was, oh shit. Have a quick look at the chat I'm having with the developer of Pokemon Apex. Because like I say, he's after artists, and I'm just I am trying to help. I want to help. I would like to help him find an artist to help him develop the game faster. Because normally, faster is better. New mods. What new mods are there? Scania T. So I should be able to enable some more of these mods I turned off. So the Renault T, maybe we can activate that. Because the issue I was having before was with the Scania T 10x6, which I fixed that now. So everything else should work. Let's hope, shall we? Should we have a look? So continue game. Let's see if this works. It should work. Let's see why it wouldn't. Da 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 da. Da da da. Da no. Logo. Tell you what, fucking is it on? It was their logo. Damn. The numbers make good reading, they do. do some Tropicana right now. Oh, lovely. Gorgeous stuff. Little glass of what you need. Here it is. Come on. Anyway, what is it you said? Let's try and work out what that says, shall we? What you typed there. So, let's do Google. Let's do translate. So, the text language. So, let's send the text. So, Como bakes our Euro truck. How to download Euro Truck. Ah, right, okay. Are you still there, Clayton? And I will help you. If you're still there, then I'll help you. It's Portuguese. For some reason, I'm popular in Portugal. I don't know why. Salva. That's slave. Salva. English. Right, so we change it to Portuguese. There's P, 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 P. Portuguese. Save. Okay, I don't know. Clayton, if you're still there, I'll tell you how to download it. But let me know if you're still there, then I'll have a look. Right. Why do I have this? Hold on, no, I need to load the game again, don't I? I need to load my single plat. Shit. Oh, I need to press delete there. Load. Load game. Load single player. That's right, isn't it? See if it breaks it. Normally it does. Well, so that's doing that. I'm gonna make a drink. Back in a second. Took all that time. I went downstairs to go get a drink. Actually, fire up the fucking game. Oh my god. You're like, oh, okay, we're in the game. Oh, yes, yes. Quickly. I'm about to quickly show you now. This is my modified Scania T. So we had a 10x6. Originally, the red one. But that broke. So I've changed the actual configuration to a 8x4 with a lifty steered axle in the middle. Change colour, like colour. It's meant to be like a midnight blue, but in certain lights it looks a lot more like a purple. But it's fucking gorgeous, I do love it. Very similar interior. Lights on the back are very similar. There are lights inside, the old Scania line thing lights up. Do it like that. Yeah, that's that. So let's have a look at the Renault. Oh, my mouse is over there somewhere. Let's see if we can find a T-Series Renault. I think it's called T-Series. No, No, game's about to crash, isn't it? Yeah. Game's crashed. Okay, so the T-Series Renault on... not in the workshop isn't working. Okay, so that's understandable. So, let me get rid of that mod. So, new mods found. Where's the Renault T information? Can I delete this one? No, because I didn't get this off the workshop, did I? No. So, let's get rid of those ones. I'll delete those ones out of the folder. Let's go into this. You can't see this. I'm on the workshop at the moment. I'll sort of put in Renault T to see what it comes out with. So it comes out with the Renault T, but they're all skins, they're not the actual truck itself. As soon as I try it, we'll have a Stobart truck skins. Renault T. That's range T, isn't it? It's not a series, it's a range T. Right, in that case, right, what we'll quickly do is I will come out of the game. So I'm not in the game a second, so you won't see it moving. What I will do is I will go to a mod site and just try and find one. Renault T range mod. ETS 2 mods part 2. That's a skin pack. That's a skin. I don't want a skin pack, I want the actual truck itself, please. Version 1.10x. This was from 2014. Fuck me, is that truck that old? Christ alive. 1.12. That was 2014 as well. So that's probably out of date. First, but go away. Categories, trucks, search. Renault Range T low cab. That's a fucking modded one. Don't want that. 1.21S 2014. That's stuff. There's no up to date ones. Renault Magnum. Don't want a Magnum. That's not what I want. Okay. Right, let's go back to Google. Back. Come on. Renault 1.23x, here we go. Names, mods. So Renault's work in progress. Replaces Renault Premium, revised shadow, retextured lights, added more tuning, added rear interior. Don't crash in game anymore. You need to download both parts. In first part, we have interior and sound. And blah, 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 blah. Interior files are blocked. Okay. Okay, so this was put up 2016, April 2016. Let's have a look at this one then. Where is the download button? This one. So, part one. Free download. Download file. Yep. Thank you. Let me go into the mods folder actually and just make sure we've got that rid of the other one. So don't clash. Where is it? Your truck 2, mods, Renault T, and that Renault T. Delete that bad boy. Leave that folder open so we can drag over the stuff. Oh, that you can see my mod folder. Let's get rid of that off screen, shall we? Let's put that over there. So let's go back to here. Let's download part 2. as well at the same time. Free download. Yes, put down the adverts for me. Go on, put loads of adverts on me. Tell me I need to grow my penis several times. Right, get rid of that window. Get rid of all these other windows. Game servers go away. Untitled Google Chrome go away. Tony Blair admits he was left bemused by the rise of Donald Trump and Jeremy Corbyn. Yep, go away. I do throw a lot of bollocks at me sometimes. Okay, so we've got one part. So it's showing folder. So it should be an SES file. Run OT, yes. Is the other one done as well? 29 seconds. So we want to drag that into there. Is that right? Yeah, it's gone in. So we're waiting for the other one. 23 seconds. T1.23 part 2. 1.23 part 2. Done. 3, 2, 1. Lovely jubbly. Right, here we go. Let's close that down. I just want to change something else as well at the same time whilst I'm here. I want to go to new window, live dashboard. I just want to change the description of the video just so people will get invited to it. And mods. There we go. Alright, let that save. We'll change to save, thank god. Alright, close that. Let's go back to the game. So we should be able to come out of this folder, out of this mod manager. Or will it come in here? I don't know if they're the ones or not, so let's come out. Mod manager again. Should pick up. There we go. We've actually got pictures now, so this one might work. That'd be chubby. Right. So these ones aren't working. So we get rid of them. Get rid of that. Get this one in. Run OT by Stas556. Oh, that's pretty good. Come on. Part one, part two. Yeah, priorities like that. Save that. Let's click it in. Fingers crossed this shall work. Yeah, that one. This thing, this game is taking fucking longer and longer to load up. Riveting stuff this is. Riveting gameplay. Advert for the Warcraft movie. I just seriously hope they haven't showed all the best bits in the adverts. I'm gonna go see that, by the way. Warcraft. That was World of Warcraft was a game that I played a lot. And I mean I took days off work to play a lot. Used to play through Friday night, constantly, non-stop, wouldn't stop. You'd stop for a toilet, you'd stop to get the food, but then you'd take the laptop once you cooked it. you play from Friday night to Sunday midday. Then after that, you then go out and do some stuff. But yeah, there was four of us that done it. It was fucking nuts, mate. They were fucking nuts. Got a truck that's trying to find this Renault. So Renault trucks should replace the Renault Premium, which is their standard size sort of truck. It's gonna crash on it. You bitch! Why can't the why don't the Renaults work? I wonder if I take other stuff out. Maybe, no. Let's try once more. So. Alright, one more try. So, new mods found. So, there are no. Let's take ones that we weren't using out, so RGL, yeah, take that one out. So this, you've got Pro Mods and the Renault T, because we want the Pro Mods to work. So, confirm changes. Yeah, let's go. Let's roll it back to... No, let's go with the one that crashed. Just go with that one. If it doesn't work now, then it ain't gonna work at all. I wonder if it's clashing with another mod or something. Bloody seat. It's got a really horrible squeak on at the moment. Come on. Sorry, watching TV at the same time. Riveting stuff. Right, one more try. So, Renault trucks. Let's pick on Dusseldorf. Buy R9. Nope. Okay, don't work. Cannot get a Renault T to work. Close program. Okay, so, let's do without that then. Right, let's go back in. Get rid of that mod. Maybe I can't get it work without Pro Mods work, I don't know. Oh, go away. So, Mod Manager. Let's get rid of the T, that one. Let's bring back that. Hold on, where's my... Oh, sorry, panic there. Bring that back in. No. Yeah, bring that back in. We can bring that back in as well, so that should work. Yeah, we should be good with that one. The old realistic physics one. Let's continue game. Get it working. Cool. Go to that. Count us. Steering wheel just clicked. Stop it. Freaking me out. Okay, so we'll do one shortish journey in the, you know, T-Series Scania, and then we'll call it a night, I think. Oh, and a Kit Kat. Go and lay yourself on the bed then. Go and chill out. Right. Is my scanner not working now? Or am I on the wrong save file? Ah, nice. Is that why the reason why T wasn't working? Am I on the wrong save file? Oh, shit. I really hope that's not the reason. I might have loaded the wrong save file. Come on, load up. Give me a second. The cat is not laying on the girl's coat. The missus' coat, she'll fucking go skin. Right. So I wonder if the T wasn't working because of the save file. Not sure. Let's not worry about that anymore. We're in the Scania T now. So let's pick a job quickly. Get it going, shall we? Actually, no, we need to sleep. Because otherwise they'll be reset anyway. Right. Oh, fucking wires. Nuts! He's driving the door. And stop at rest. And it's night time. Oh, yes. Right, let's pick a job. Oh shit, my mum. Right, freight markets. Let us pick. Ah, oh, those are all strange companies. How far is that? That's a lot further than it looks. I'll tell you that for a fact. Ice cream, Rotterdam to Munich. We could do that one, I suppose. We could jump, actually. Let's do a jump. Let's go somewhere more interesting. Map view. So we're here. Should we go further up this way? Maybe we can go here and get something from around this area. Let's go there. So quick travel here. Yes. There's always a long delay in either now. Right, let's find the old jobby job. Fuck out, Italy. Oh, krona. Oh, fucking hell, Swedish krona. I thought that was fucking £703,000. That's ridiculous money. Right, so they're going to Italy. I only want one down locally. Oh, fucking ridiculous. You that far. 15 ton. Of, no, 8 ton. That's 8 ton, isn't it? Poland. That's a strange way around. Helsinki to Helsinki? Nah. A little bit further than that. Let's go a bit north in Finland and let's go past these lakes and stuff. So 18 tons of iron pipes is a good, decent amount as well. Set as GPS. And we have got rain. So what's my button for rain? That's my beacon. Don't need that yet. It's that one. Right. Some frames. Frame loss because of the rain, maybe. That was the town. I'll get the town actually. Don't see feckle. Let's go anyway. I think I spun the lift axle up. Lift it up. Yeah, it has, yeah. Cool, right, let's go. That is my cruise control. So, check out 55. What is my phone so loud all of a sudden? Hello, turn. Oh, I forgot this is a very shit turn, isn't it? Come on, keep away from the barrier. Good girl. Oh yeah, realistic physics. It's a bit more bouncy now. No one's coming that way, no one's coming that way. We're good, let's go. Keep out of that lane. Da 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 da. What did my phone go off for anyway? Sorry, YouTube notification. It was a YouTube notification. And does tickle. turn off is here. Oh, come on, break. Let's take that. Look at that, Renner's catching up quick. Welcome to Helsinki. Let's be going this fast. Let's knock it down a bit. Oh, turn into here anyway. Cool. Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain.
Let's go. Let's go to this. Stop. Handbrake. Enter. Hold on a jiffy. Is this where we're meant to be going? Well, it was. Looks like our job's gone. And why the hell did we go all the way around here? Okay, let's try and find another job then. Flight markets. Bloody hell then. I need to get a thing, don't I? Right, put out that thing. Handbrake, map. Freight market. Helsinki. Quite short journeys. Kemi. Is that the one we picked? Put a short one in that, but fuck it, let's go with that one. Set a GPS. Right, let's go again. Hello. Stop that. Can't see really. I'm straight here, sorry, apologies. Skoda. Kunagal. Is there a brand on that trailer, by the way? Lights. I'm assuming the same as them lights over there, so I'll keep an eye on them ones. And try and read messages at the same time. What a good boy I am. Ah, the lights fucking change. Hold on. Hold on, Ben. You are fucking rad old driver you are. Ah. Right. It's here on the left, little construction site by the looks of it. There we go. It's a white turn for no reason at all. And bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Right, what we got? Morgan McLennan? McLennan? Cottage cheese. 18 tons of cottage cheese. Fucking hell, that's a lot of cheese. Right. Let's bring it around and around and around. Right, so we're attaching that. Let's put the old lift axle down. Let's go. See how the physics react to this. Fucking lights. I see how the physics reacts. It's only an 18 ton trailer, so it should be okay. Left-hand turn up here. Coolnet Nagel. Changing. Cars are pulling out. Better keep moving, Sonny. Stops in. Nice and sunny earlier. Right, about 50 here. Stay down for this. Get power gun. Take it for 60 just for speed sake. That Persian needs to get out of my way. Come on, you dick. Right, I'm good, yeah. It's getting tight. That's right, mate. Right, another tight turn off coming up here. Up here around a bend, brought this truck in. Then that's the truck? No, that's Azra, is it? No, that's Abby. What's Abby? What do we do? Fuck me, he's going around that bend quite quick. Nothing that way. Let's think there's anything that way. Turn the wipers off in a second. Like that. Let me see. Can't see the lights on the trailer on. You can't see them when you got like a low bed trailer on. Turning up here. I just have a shot completely. No, I haven't. I think I've done actually quite well, actually. I have, look at that. Car, there it is. That's got up his ass. On this journey. Oh, that's a lot longer than I thought it was going to be. Right, I'll sit back and chill. Oh, hello. Drift King here. Not the sort I'm told you to drift. Hey, stop it. Keep under control, boy. Fancy looking bridge. Get combine arm rushing over there. I'll turn it off. And he missed it. Why are you going so slow? Throw down this guy's head's been a dick. Right, out of the way, Sanjoy. Okay, it's not going that way, it's closing up. Slow down, slow down, slow down. Pump the brakes. Okay, that's good, that's good. Oh, danger bird. Tell me all myself. the satellites on. I'm gonna have to take this truck now. No, I can't. There you go, that post. Another go overtaken. It's gonna end up quite nasty. And down the single lane again, I'm breaking. Because we don't know what the AI is looking this game. Junction. Stop there. Junction here. Yeah? Racing line from here. Don't look over that. Slow down this bend. So I just put glass out of the way because I was sort of tucking into the screen. I couldn't quite see the GPS. go to the truck, catch up with his truck. Unless we can get a dual carriage and get around him. Hello, sorry, I wasn't paying attention, I was watching TV. And the guy just ran me on the arse, I think. The car behind me? Or was just, that was at the physics, might have just been the physics section. That's all, matey. That's a roundabout. I'll pay attention again. a nice chilled out drive. Barely spoke. Said she was sitting back, chilling out and driving. Love it. Junction coming up here. What junction? That could spin me out. Spin me right round, baby, right round. Car park. Nearly there. Are you ready? I just need to do something for a second there. Apologies. Not letting that cat land that fucking coat. This will kill me. He's gonna let me out. Oh, Mr. Blue Volvo. What's she going to do again? Kerry. Oh, shut up. You start yawning with that close. So I'll do some work, shall we? It's time for a rest, quickly. Next rest stop remains 15 hours, here we do. Let's have a rest stop. That was an encroachment of the next job. Engine off. I went too far, didn't I? Sleep. Fantastic. Get the old lights going. Let's go. Can't see that from the YV mirror. Not really, though. Any fucking air anyway. One drop off place. It's only a town, is it? Didn't indicate the other. I'm a dick. Go this way around. This might be the best truck for this sort of place. Hazards down, I think. sensors. After the blind side. Right, okay. Yeah, okay. Not gonna do it that way. No way. Scrub the old trailer, shall we? This bad boy right round. There's a ranger over there somewhere. Oh, did I clear that post? Yeah, I am. Right. Enough, I think it is. Well, do whatever. Have your old job. Excellent, yada 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 yada. Fantastic. Okay, so that's it. That's the stream down basically. So yeah, just go over what we've been doing basically. So the main thing of this stream was the advanced coupling that SES is gonna bring out in the 1.24 update, so that'll be coming soon. Download the beta, have a crack at it, see what you think, let me know. Played around some mods, I need to try and work out to get a range T Scania working, range T Renault working. What else have we done? Had a look at the car mod, the scale mod. I'm gonna have a look at more cars. I'm actually doing that right now, actually, before I go to bed quickly, so we can get some working. Yeah, that's about it, really. Yeah, that's it. Nice, that was a nice chilled out stream. I was got through some stuff, some important stuff I need to get through, some stuff, things and stuff. Yeah, cool. But yeah, we're done. And we had a nice chilled out drive through Finland. Yeah. So thank you to everyone who come along. Thank you to GamerZan who subscribed. There will be some Farm Sim 15. Might be tomorrow or it might be Friday. We'll see. Be subscribed, you'll see. Clayton Santos, if you come back, then I will show you how to download Euroshock 2. Obviously, it's not gonna be cheap. It's gonna be a cost to it. Yeah, that is it. Look at our nearly 2.5 hours long stream. We've been going for a while. I think it's maybe one of the longest streams we've ever done. Maybe, we'll see. But yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and I shall talk to you very, very soon. Bye bye.